me about this album, I pretty much try to leave some mystery to it. Because I love it so much, I don't want anyone to take what I say as meaning one thing.
Every song, from song to song, tells a story. Maybe the most complete album in that sense that we've ever done.
It's the first album that someone came in and brought something out of this band that hadn't been brought out of this band yet.
The freshness of the album came from the fact that we just sort of built the album from the ground up.
Hey Dave, that thing's in G, right?
Yeah, it goes to this bridge, and then
I think everyone in this record had a chance to start tunes, to finish tunes. It was just a different process, but it sounds just like us.
Most albums that we record, I will put it in the CD player and listen once or twice. But with this album, it's funny because when I put it in, I forget that it's even in there, and I get detached from it. And that's a good thing, because it means that I really like it.
There's a harder rock sound to it in some songs. There's a harder funk sound to it in some songs. There's a more of a almost an international feel to it in a lot of the songs. American Baby, it's got like a sort of a funky African kind of groove to it. So that's the sound that came together from just the pieces of all individuals of the band.
American Baby, the first single, started with BT just sort of warming up in the studio, and he was just sitting there plucking. And then thinking that after that, you're gonna start working on a song or whatever. And he got into this lick, and then I walked in, and there was this cool vibe on that lick, and I just put some chords around it. And then Carter changed the beat up, and it turned the whole thing kind of inside out.
The percussion stuff, for me, was an extra for sure on this album. And the reason for that is my traps playing wasn't laid back. It was still strong, but it wasn't as busy, which allowed the drums and the percussion to kind of dance together without stepping on each other's toes.
Ooh, I'm afraid we've lost the way. Stay.
That was nice. It's just up there, and it's my first one of the day. Forgive me, sir.
Dave's vocals, the way he sings on this record is remarkable, actually.
Take me back to that beat again.
We got to keep working on that.
And there was Dream Girl, I think it was, that it stands out. It's like a ballet almost.
We recorded it. We started with a little guitar loop. So then I just went in. I said, I think I got the verses, but I didn't know exactly how they were going to fit. And I hadn't sung them ever before. So it came out in this really loose and kind of conversational tone.
You know, everything is like dancing and pausing, and it's like this thing that has come to life, you know. It's actually breathing, you know, and it's actually living. So, and that's what music is all about.
Everybody experimented on this album. I believe Stefan played some electric guitar on this album, you know, and I believe Dave played some piano. I played electric mandolin. I've been thinking about playing mandolin for, you know, really a couple of years. It opened up a whole new world for me on the album. It was the freedom of the process of this recording that really just sort of brought out everybody's, you know, I think the best of what everybody had to offer for this album.
Here you go, you dirty girl. Good God.
It's a matter of finding your own individual voice and showing it.
You know that I love you.
And playing it in a mass collective. So when we're together in the studio, it's more, you know, you have to listen, you have to be open to people's ideas.
I think that comes with focus and just remembering what we are doing, why we're doing it, you know, who we're doing it with, you know, where it came from, where it's come, and where it is, you know.
It was just like a really open and free creative process, because it's really just a really true reflection, if you will, of the Dave Matthews Band sound.